Good afternoon, students. Welcome to Game 6. Gross and microscopy explained. The topic for the day is squamous cell carcinoma, which can be a short note in pathology or surgery, a spotter or a specimen for description, a slide or an MCQ. I would like you people to kindly superimpose these gross and microscopic descriptions onto the specimens and slides that you have got in your college. Moreover, these can be asked as short notes for your examination. And it will be dealt under the following headings. Please go through them. Let us see how to describe a specimen. This is an amputated specimen of the penis. The glans penis, the prepuce, and even a part of the shaft have been replaced by a large, proliferating, friable, and foul-smelling growth, which is measuring several centimeters. And this is analogous to the vegetable that you see at the insert. This is a cauliflower and it looks almost exactly the same. So it is proliferating, friable. If you nibble at it, it will come off. It has got exactly the same property. A squamous cell carcinoma can be from 1 to 2 centimeters to several centimeters in diameter. A new specimen will be foul smelling because of the autolysis. But the specimens in your museum jars are not, because they have been fixed in formalin. This is another specimen wherein I am finding a growth that is infiltrating and destroying the prepuce and the glans penis. And it can even be invading the shaft. That is why the surgeon does an amputation of the penis. What are the causes for a squamous cell carcinoma? It can arise de novo, that is anew on its own, or it can be because of sharp dentition. The oral cavity is very notorious for it. Smoking. Marjolin's ulcer is a chronic non-healing leg ulcer that can result in a squamous cell carcinoma. In the cervix, the viruses, human papilloma virus 16 and 18, are supposed to pave way for an SCC. The other causes can be radiation and xeroderma pigmentosum. And this is a specimen of the lung. In fact, I'm seeing a cut surface of the lung that is showing a large tumor. The tumor is large and ovoid, and it is grayish white in color. It is friable. I can appreciate it even on the picture. The moment we start meddling with it, parts of it will come off. That is why we call it friable. Nobody believes. It is a specimen of the larynx, and it has been replaced by a large cauliflower-like growth. And the same description, it is friable, grayish white in color. Grossly, the squamous cell carcinoma can be of any of the following types. It can be proliferative or multiplying, or it can be ulcerative, or it can be a combination of both ulcer or proliferative. So these are the three types of gross presentations of a squamous cell carcinoma. Look at this one, it is totally different. It is an ulcer, but a large ulcer at the foot. And I find that it is having grayish white areas, there are areas of hemorrhage, and there are areas of necrosis which are black in color. So the sole of the foot, it is showing a very large tumor. What are all the other sites where we can get a squamous cell carcinoma? It can be the skin, oral cavity, upper respiratory tract, lung, esophagus, uterine, cervix. In fact, wherever you have got squamous epithelium, you can get a squamous cell carcinoma. Let us look at the microscopic pictures. So this is a microscopic picture of a squamous cell carcinoma. The moment you see it, you can make a diagnosis. So these are all nests of epithelial cells. Look at this one, nest. So it is a nest of these tumor cells, and the tumor cells are concentrically arranged around each other. So they form what is called an epithelial pearl. Epithelial pearl is classical of squamous cell carcinoma. Pearl is actually a secretion that is formed by the oyster. As more and more secretions are deposited, they harden into a beautiful jewel which you buy and wear. I said it is in the form of nests over here. Sometimes you find that they can be long cord-like structures. And this is the supporting stroma that is having all the blue dots are all inflammatory lymphocytes. I hope you people are able to appreciate this picture. Again, moment I see it, I find that there are multiple nests of these tumor cells, and these arrows are pointing out to the epithelial pearls. And what are epithelial pearls? Concentric arrangement of the tumor cells, which are more eosinophilic, and they are there at the nidus of it. And these are the various nests of the tumor cells, and the tumor can be seen infiltrating the fibrocollagenous stroma. The marker for it can be keratin. This is a classification. You need not know it in detail, but just observe. A tumor can be well differentiated, moderately differentiated, poorly differentiated, or anaplastic. And accordingly, you find that there will be more keratinization or epithelial pearls in a well differentiated tumor. They will be absent in an anaplastic tumor. Mitosis will be scanty in a well-differentiated tumor, and you find that there will be increased and atypical as the grading goes on. This is called the Broder's classification. You people can mention it if you get a question on it. And a slide for description. Look at the large nests of these tumor cells. The white arrow is the nest over here, and the blue arrow points out to the epithelial pearl. In the examination, one such focus will be kept, and you people can straight away make a diagnosis by means of the epithelial pearls. And here I am finding the yellow one is large polygonal cells. So this is a slide of squamous cell carcinoma, absolutely no difficulty. And you can even answer it in the examination. See you in game 7.